we were gonna tear it all down. The Institute, Providence, everyone who'd ever hurt us. We failed. The partners grew paranoid, made sure that Ortmeier's children would never challenge them again. I'm the only one who got away unchanged. The only one left who remembers.
Ortmeier was Providence.
Everything he did to us, everything he made us do, it all leads back to them.
I'm breaking more rules than I care to count, Mr. Gray. What's your play?
The partners hide behind a cloak of anonymity. Only one man knows their true identities. Your client, the top controller, the one they call the Constant. He is the key.
But he is untraceable. So what am I missing?
A man would come to the Institute. A man with a Providence pin. The first Constant. If we find him, if he's still alive, he's our way in.
You don't know who he is, but 47 does. That's what this reunion is all about.
Show them.
You're just gonna hand it over. Our one bargaining chip.
Olivia.
Fine. 47's memory was erased, irreversibly at the time. But after Ortmeier's death, his estate was acquired by the Ether Corporation. And they made an antidote.
It's a long shot, I know.
This is not how it works. We don't just join the revolution. ICA is neutral. We don't take sides.
I hate to break it to you, lady, but neutrality is a side. It's the side of the status quo.
People have died. Civilians. You align yourself with terrorists, murderers.
Sometimes even monsters serve a purpose.
Look.
Enough. You have a choice. But I made mine a long time ago. I will finish what I started.
Subject 47, most gifted of all my boys.
So you're the pick of the litter. Tell me about the incident.
The subject ran away, he and another boy. The instigator was punished accordingly.
As were all the neighbors.
My men did what needed to be done. It won't happen again. Bring your house in order, Doctor. You won't like the alternative.
I remember who he is.
Gentlemen, let's go over the plan. The first Constant is none other than Janus, the legendary Cold War spymaster, a KGB senior officer and head of the 6th Column Special Branch at Lubyanka. Janus is a certified genius and expert of counterintelligence. He retired from the KGB in 1988 when he fell out of favor with the Kremlin and defected to the US. Shortly after, the Soviet Union collapsed. Now, it is unclear when Janus stepped down as the Constant, but since 2004, he has been a resident of a quiet community in suburban Vermont. Mr. Gray.
Right. So here's the catch. As an elite KGB agent, Janus was trained to withstand interrogation and torture. No amount of pressure will force him to disclose information he doesn't want to. Instead, we will need to search his home for clues. But if Providence learns of our presence, the game is up.
So we frame Janus, make Providence think he was the real shadow plant.
Correct. I will file a false ICA report, claiming to have traced a number of calls from Janus's house to the Institute in Romania. The case would seem clear. Mr. Gray was only a figurehead. Janus was pulling the strings all along. And by eliminating him, we will have neutralized the militia once and for all.
However, for this subterfuge to work, you'll also need to deal with Janus's security detail. A Providence Herald and former Secret Service agent by the name of Nolan Cassidy. Intel describes him as diligent and inquisitive, and we cannot risk that he contradicts our story to his employer.
Seems workable.
I certainly hope so. Everything depends on this next move, 47. You made this our fight. Now let's even the playing field. Whittleton Creek, Vermont. On the surface, a picture-perfect suburban dream. Wide roads, golden maple trees, and verdant lawns. Most residents here are white-collar professionals, ranging from university staff to government employees.
Most, but not all. Janus's unpresuming home is protected by a host of bodyguards, and intel shows that the fragile former constant rarely leaves the property.
Nolan Cassidy, on the other hand, roams the neighborhood streets. A recent arrival, the dutiful Providence Herald is busy making threat assessments and settling in with his security team.
Now remember, this is about more than just revenge. Janus is the key to bring down Providence. So get in there and find us a lead.
Good luck, 47.
Change the world. Vote Blake.
Say, you guys haven't been poking around the frog habitat behind the house, have you?
No.
Oh, okay, great. It's just that, I saw one of those security people from Mr. Janus's house, and I'm pretty sure he was burying something back there, and I just figured since you guys seem to be, you know, working together, you might know about it.
Can't say that I...
Someone from Janus' security detail buried something in the frog habitat behind Cassidy's house. What could that possibly be? A cigar box with a few cigars and a note inside. Well, this is very interesting. The note indicates that the box was given to Janus by the Constant as per tradition, he writes. 47, this could mean the Constant and Janus meet up on a regular basis. Excellent find.
Neighborhood barbecue party. How suburban.
My belly is rumbling a little.
Want to go inside? Looks like everyone's invited.
Would be a good time to coax some information out of unsuspecting locals.
Oh, jeez, darling, I'm so hungry. Have you seen those beautiful patties back there? And Mr. Wilson just keeps standing behind the grill, even though there's clearly no more gas on it.
I know, it's weird. Why doesn't he go grab a new canister? I'm telling you, these new folks are strange. Did you see that Cassidy guy snooping around here? He's been looking at the party 3 times already. Why not just go inside? It's open to everyone.
Yeah,
The Wilsons are throwing a barbecue and everyone's invited. It sounds like Nolan Cassidy has some interest in the party as well, but for some reason, he's unwilling to go inside. Maybe you can help fix whatever's wrong in there, 47.
Strange, all right. Oh, maybe he's a vegan. I don't trust the man who can't eat a rare steak.
So beautiful. I'm really impressed by all the wonderful things you have here. I wish my husband would let me have that much art inside the house. Isn't it beautiful?
Richard, you are psychoing propane tank. If you could just hook that up here. Oh, wow. Will you look at that? It's good to know the kind and helpful people still exist. Guess I have to start flipping burgers now.
You know, my youngest just had her first piano recital. She did a Chopin. Her teacher said she...
Will you look at this? The furniture looks brand new.
Well, they did just move here recently.
People normally don't buy new furniture every time they move into a new place, Al. And if you remember... Stop!
Do I know him?
So I'm going to stop prattling on and let you all enjoy the barbecue. Please don't be shy. Come up and introduce yourself. We're just dying to get to know you all. Don't hesitate to ask Richard about his books or to coax my best cheesecake recipe loose. Whatever you like. We don't bite, do we, huh?
Nope.
Hey, you, what's your name? El camarero, you, the server. Hey, hello. Anyone there?
Hi there. Care for a taste?
You say what?
I can't deal with it. I just can't.
All right, folks. The food is ready.
Hey, much appreciated.
No, thank you.
Nolan,
pardon me. Can I offer you a little treat?
Jesus.
Well, feel free to make another guest.
Thanks.
Sure thing.
I'm sure everything will be just to your liking.
Who wants a taste? You? Go ahead.
Wow.
Finally.
Ooh, do I feel special.
Right here.
It's nothing.
Start serving people, all right?
Excuse me. Careful,
well,
snack.
Looks pretty busy here. I'll just wait my turn.
That's what he likes his food, 47.
Cheers.
Anytime.
Hey,
wrap your lips around this.
Ah, wait a minute.
Thank you.
Glad to be of service.
Thank you very much.
Last time I met someone,
the restroom better be vacant.
What?
Oh, okay. You need to see a doctor. Now.
Honestly, Richard's the exciting one.
Hmm?
I just keep busy in my own way.
Oh, shit. You are not okay.
Uh-huh.
Not feeling too hot, huh?
What?
Hey, you look sick. You should go see a doctor. Now.
What?
We're heading to the Maldives soon for a bit of a trip. Oh, it's going to be amazing.
You should really hey there, big guy.
Hey! Oh!
Nolan Cassidy is down. Good work, 47. Janus awaits your attention.
What's your take on these Wilson people, Penelope?
They seem very nice.
Why to be exactly? They're perfect.
Yeah, Doc, I know. That is guy.
Seen that Janice's oddball nurse is at it again.
Oh yeah, the bird guy.
I think he comes early, just to chat with the birds. Spends more time with them than he does with Janice.
A couple of weeks ago.
So Janice has an appointment with a male nurse every Saturday. He is down feeding the birds by the creek at the moment. Sounds like a good way inside Janice's house.
I walked past him and I have to tell you, he gets into some pretty personal stuff with me.
He shared his opinion on Janice. Let's just say it's
not exactly. Oh, no way.
He's been sitting there most of the day. I don't know what he's reading, but it looks like it's the most interesting thing he's ever come across.
The new Cassandra Stone novel, maybe. Slivers of Past Shimmers, or something like that. See, my wife's reading it now. I can't get her to do anything around the house.
No, it's not a novel. I think it's a journal, or a diary. He's one of the security people working over at that old Russian guy's house. It's gotta be something from the old man's archives.
If that's one of Janus's diaries, it might contain some important information about his past. Our past.
Or maybe something that can help us locate the constant.
Okay.
Hello? Is anyone there? Who made that sound?
Mm-hmm.
Janus's many diaries. He's apparently been the chairman of the Ark Society for years. He stepped down very recently, but is still attached to the society. Well, 47, this is valuable information.
Wow.
Sir, I will have to check you if you want to pass, okay? This'll just take a sec, sir. Thank you.
New guy, huh?
The regular guy is indisposed. I'm here to take care of Mr. Janus.
All right. Just ring the doorbell. Someone will be with you in a moment.
Who are you? Where's Lafayette?
He's not well.
Hopefully it's something serious. I wouldn't mind if Lafayette was replaced permanently. He's an insufferable bore with a room temperature IQ. But if you're the new guy, you'll need to be on time. I have a busy schedule, you know. You have a very distinct face, my friend. Eastern European, am I right? But more than that, a refined mix of cultures. You look almost like an artist's rendering of the perfect man. I knew a man once.
A doctor.
Oh. Wait, what? Wonderful. Yes. This takes me back. The night I passed the torch. End of an era as Constant. We had the Vienna Philharmonic play it that night. Empty concert hall except for the two of us. A rare moment indeed. A good talk, hands shaken, honor among men. As it should be. I wonder if he remembers it as vividly as I do. I should ask him when we meet again soon.
So, that piece of music sparked a memory in Janus's mind, and we now have confirmation that he and the Constant will be meeting each other soon. Great work, 47. Good work, 47. We now know Janus is meeting with the Constant at an event related to the Ark Society. And we have an approximate date as well. I think that's all we're going to get.
We're close to the finish line. It's time to end this.
So, back to this thing. I'll just spend a few minutes with the inhaler to fill my system with as much oxygen as possible before we proceed to the bathroom for the health check itself.
Well, while Mr. Janus fills his lungs, I'd like a quick word with you. Please, come with me. All right, new guy. I know this looks like a relaxed operation, but I run a tight ship. Nobody gets alone time with Janice unless I know them, and I don't know you. So here's what I'll do. I'm going downstairs to run a security check on you. It should only be a few minutes. In the meantime, you wait in the study. We'll lock the doors and my men will make sure you don't accidentally wander off. I'm sure you understand. Please, wait in there.
'47, you have to find a way out of there. I can't possibly construct a viable ID for you in time. I'll have Miss Hall remotely interfere with their search, but we can't keep it up for long. That was certainly an interesting turn of events. Still, no rest for the wicked, 47. You could probably slip back inside and give Janus his health check while his bodyguard is busy. Just be mindful of the patrolling guards.
I'm back. I suggest we go to the bathroom now.
All right. Let's go then. Sir.
Nicely done, 47. It's time for Janus to pay for his crimes.
You know, you remind me of someone I met a long time ago. A young boy in Romania.
Tell me more about this boy.
The boy. I remember his eyes better than anything. Ice cold, defiant.
Thus, the actions of the first constant catch up with him. Death feels like an easy way out for a man like Janus. Still, Society. One of Providence's more
obscure outfits.
I've heard whispers. A survivalist club for the global elite. Billionaires preparing for a global collapse. And now we know the Constant will attend their next gathering. So where is it?
That's the catch. The report is redacted. No names, no location.
So it's a dead end. I can't track them, not without ICA backup.
Now, I'm no big shot analyst, but it seems to me Janus was the Ark Society's founder, so chances are they'll want to pay their respects in private.
Track the coffin. Worth a shot.
You all right? It comes back in flashes. Fear, anger, but like it happened to someone else.
Your gift and your curse. What they did to you. Well, I spent a long time feeling guilty about that. Now, I wonder who got the better deal.
Yes. Found something.
What are we looking at?
The ass end of nowhere. But this is where Janus's remains were shipped to. Our choice for a final resting place, wouldn't you say?
Not bad. So we stake it out. Await the next gathering. Then we waltz in and kidnap one of the world's most powerful men. Without ICA backup.
Like I said, it's a long shot.
We'll take it.